Minecraft, larger than Earth. They must be describing the feel of areas in the fourth intersection of Uncharted Territory 2. With Brian, we are going to continue playing on today where we left off last time. We're still trying to get through the sands of despair. I'm going to find something useful this episode. Let's get started. Ooh, and I'm going to rename another object as well. Welcome back to Uncharted Territory 2. Last time I said I was going to run in here, and so I guess let's run in here. I'm nervous. Gonna drink a regen and a speed. And then we opened up a room on the right that may still have bad guys in it, and it does. And so let's charge in and see what all is in here. Hello. Alright, that's not so bad. I hear pigmen. That way's blocked off for the moment. I just want to see, does this actually go down to somewhere? Yes, it does look like it actually does go down to somewhere. And that somehow feels more promising to me. I think I just didn't leave myself a way back up. And I hear more pigment. Oops, let's be careful with the speed. Both the speed of my pick and the speed of me running around. Okay, and these pigmen seem angry. And they seem to have a potion effect. Yep, and they are angry, and they are hitting hard. Okay, great. They don't have good pathfinding, and I do have weapons. And so, let's see if I can take them on. I still got the, And so, where did they spawn? Okay, right here. Alright, so, I still have regen going. Let's find the spawner. There it is. Gosh, this pick is almost too good. Let's keep... Okay, that goes... Oh, dear. Okay, there's a pigman behind me. Okay, so you must have just spawned again somewhere along here. There it is. Okay, pigman spawner. Let's go ahead and take out a few more just in case. All right, and there's more pigmen in this... Is that... Oh, it's water in there. Okay, crazy. Oh, my gosh. Look at this whole area. There's like a whole subterranean something in here. All right, I guess I'm safe... Alright, let's think about where we're at right now. I'm safe right now over there. I hear like some skeletons who might be like above me or something. I still have, let's get another regen on the bar in case we need it in speed. I might already be in a little over my head here. I hear Pigman. Let's just get some light around here. Let's beware of falling. Gosh, this area is crazy. All right, is there any kind of way down? It kind of goes down. And I've got the right pick to make good staircases. So let's go down. Seems like we're getting away from... Oh, I see a spawner over here. It's Silverfish. Okay, you I can take care of. I just saw a creeper somewhere. Let's go ahead and take out... Presumably that was the Silverfish spawner. I hear footsteps, and so the creeper, I think, is just below me. I don't think there's anywhere above me where he's going to spawn. There's the creeper. Okay, great. Can I hit you from over here? You were having trouble finding a path. If I give you a path... There we go. Oh, I just looked right at the Enderman. All right, well, come and get me. All right, and that is how you do it. I think I kind of prefer these mobs to the pigmen, mostly because the pigmen terrify me, and also because this is a reasonable speed, again. I would love to see where that silverfish just spawned, so I could go ahead and take out the spawner, because that'll be annoying, because silverfish have a bit of knockback, and I could easily see them kind of like pushing me into this deep hole that I'm knocking these enemies back into. But I guess until that happens, we just need to continue moving forward. And we will use light as our primary weapon to combat the bad guys. All right. Actually, that's not true. We'll use Lacerator as our primary weapon. Oh, crap. I looked at another one. Did I actually look at him? Yep, I did. Crap. Ouch, ouch, ouch. He's mean. All right. Let's eat a delicious, delicious potato. Let's not have our cursor pointing somewhere where an Enderman might walk into the path. Let's notice the fact that we're getting low on torches. I was not expecting, like, I really thought I was going to walk in and there was going to be a little dungeon, and that was going to be it, because I'd already fought through a huge area. And nope, it's just more huge area. Because that's how the last few areas are going to be. I wonder if this will be the red wool. I think this will be the red wool. And then I think Null and Void Revenge, or whatever it's called, will be the black wool. But I was wrong when I speculated before, and so perhaps I'll be wrong again. I just feel like the red wool is like the more menacing, and the black wool... Oops, where did you spawn? Hold on. Hey, Silverfish, where are you? I don't see him anywhere. All right, well, we'll just have to keep our eyes open. Let's go ahead and start making a more discernible staircase over... Oh, hello, hello, hello. Crap. I have sharpness 3. That's probably enough to kill you regardless. Right, so I can just hit the silverfish with the sword. Let's remember that. And there's another one somewhere. But I don't see him. He sounds really close, though. He might have been, like, in a little crawl space that just opened up as a result of silverfish calling for help. All right, and I definitely... When I get down to about 15 torches, I'm going to have to head on back, because I'm not sure how safe my way back is going to be. Probably not terribly. Oh, crap, crap! All right. Didn't see where he came from. Let's step up for just a minute. I see that there's more iron over there. Not that I really need any more, but nice to know. Oops, let's not put my cursor over there. There could be Endermen that I can't really see. Iron is often trapped. Although I don't hear anything going off now. It's possible that there was an entryway into another room over there, but I would like to see where the silverfish is, if possible. So I don't see him. Was there an entryway to a room up there? No, I don't think so. All right, there's an Enderman down there that I don't want to look at, and I said if I get down to 15 torches, I was going to head back. I've got 17, 16. I think I should head back and make sure that I can actually make my way back. And yeah, this will still be a fight to get back, I expect. And so let's keep our wits about us. So we got this room that'll... Oh, hello. Hello, hello, hello. I really do love the knockback on the Lacerator. Let's try adding a little bit more light over here, since it seems like he came from over here somewhere. Oops. Wanted to put it there. Darn you vines. Okay. And here's my little staircase back up. Oh, my goodness. Okay, so there's a crazy room with water over there. And then I'm probably going to have to renovate the staircase a little bit, because I think I didn't do the best job of the staircase here. Ouch. Let's put a torch before I take out a torch. All right, great, great. Okay, we can make it back into there. And I see a creeper over there, but otherwise we're okay. I'm gonna go get some more torches and some more potions and we'll head back in. Welcome back, Skullcap. Legzo, you're my hero. And it looks like projectile protection 4. It's getting pretty worn out, but that's okay, because it seems like we fought through the skeletons, and so now might be a good time to bring back Chesty! Protection 2, that'll be good against Pigmen. Alright, I've got more supplies. We're going to try to waltz right back in here and pick up where we left off. I'm actually going to go a little bit slowly, just because I want to see if there's any other, you know, traps or things that I haven't seen, but so far... Everything still seems safe. Just want to see if any other monsters end up spawning as I travel through the hallways again and again. But it seems like we're okay. So we're going to continue on where we left off last time. Ooh, I should eat a delicious potato! And here are some leftover experience balls that haven't gone away yet. Hooray! Alright, and we lit over near the iron. Right, right. I hear a silverfish that spawned who knows where. I don't really see him right now, and so we'll just continue on. Let's add some light here, and here, and here, and here, and way up in the corner over here. And I hear a silverfish, like, right behind me. There he is. Oh, right, I don't have to get critical hits on you. I've got sharpness 3. And there's another one still somewhere. Still haven't managed to catch a glimpse of the silverfish spawner. This one seems to be further below. Oh, and there's a couple of them here, apparently. Let's start carving a staircase. Hello. Oh, I see the spawner. Great. That was very fortunate. Wow, that one's really hidden. He is trapped in there. So first of all, we'll take out the spawner, and then we'll take out the fish. The fish! The fish. Oh, here comes another fish. Hello, fish. I just heard a spider. Hello. All right. And I think I still hear another fish, but I don't know where the fish is. And I'm definitely spawning spiders somewhere. Well, I don't know that I'm actually spawning them. It could just be... The good news is they're normal spiders, and it could just be that they're spawning and climbing up from somewhere. Is there another... fish? Oh, hello. Oh, yep. There's multiple spawners here. It's a box of some sort. It might contain fun. I'm so used to critting these guys. Oh, come on. All right. Was that the last one? Oh, that's a silverfish. Yikes. Hold on. All right, you can get knocked back. The fish has lost track of me, I guess. What happened to the fish? I hear a fish very nearby. All right, but in any case, that was a 2x2 fun box, so we had 4 spawners right there together. And so that gives me a sense of what to expect. Because the last time we saw that at the beginning of an area, the area went on, and eventually, oh crap, we got to 9x9 boxes. All right, and so if the silverfish is still, oh crap. So many silverfish blocks. So did he spawn here? I almost want to just like sit here. I still hear another one. I think they're still spawning somewhere. Oh, darn it, and all these blocks are silverfish blocks. Well, the iron won't be, so let's use that as a step. Yeah, I do not want the silverfish behind me because they'll knock me down further than I want to go into this whole place, and then it will be bad. But I don't see any more spawners. Maybe he's just trapped inside somewhere and he spawned when they called for help. If he can't get to me... All right, I hear more guys coming. And this is still not great. Yuck, I don't like this at all. One second. Sorry about that, distracted by the phone. Phone going off. Alright. What do we got down here? We got remnants of bad guys. I hear a couple of bad guys. Nothing too bad so far. Let's go ahead and continue. Oops, I forgot about you guys already. Alright, many blocks are silverfish, and my pick is too good to be able to tell the difference. And I was about to say, there's a spider like right on my head, I can tell. I could hear him. I could hear the spider. He was saying, Brian, look at me, I'm on your head. And I was like, what you talking about, spider? All right, oops, and okay. Let's go ahead and knock you back. All right, you got distracted. All right, all of a sudden, we got a bunch of bad guys come up to find me. Need to make sure I'm not looking at Endermen down here, which will be hard because it's really dark and I can't see if there are Endermen down here. Still got a spider somewhere above me. There we go. And, oh my gosh. All right, this is steep, but I do still have a back to the wall, so I don't feel that bad about it, because now I can kind of use this and just fight off the bad guys with the lacerator, except for now, I didn't expect that. Okay, great. Regen, because I don't have fire resist. I didn't manage to get drink the regen. Okay. Alright, Blaze has hit me, but now I can eat some food. And Blaze will be able to fly up here, but I'll be able to get into some fire resist if I need to. Okay, okay. Spider is trapped in the little thingy over there. Fire resist will last 8 minutes, which is a good long time. But yeah, it's about to get real. That's fire resist, right? Yes, okay. We are fire resistant. We are taking care of you. We are taking care of you. We are getting the regen back on the bar. We're getting some more torches ready. And here we go. It is on. All right. Blaze in a box is in force. The blaze will now help me out rather than hurt me. See, AMLP, that's where you made a mistake. Put blazes in these areas, and the blazes are allies. They're going to light. They're going to kill bad guys. They're going to do everything I need them to do and more. All right, maybe not everything I need them to do. But still, I like having them here. And you guys are already a pain, so let's get rid of you and you. Crap. Let's use the sword. It's got sharpness. Let's use this and knock you guys back into nowhere. And let's get light up here. Okay, there's a whole nice area over here. I don't see 1,000 enemies spawning, and so I'm not too worried about, like, a giant fun box over here. All right. Let's get some guys in front of me. Back to the wall. Yeah. All right, we've done this before. This is just, like, the quiet. I feel like I'm back. Oh, crap, crap! In my element, mostly. Apparently there was something behind me over there, so I didn't quite have my back to the wall. I see that Stabby has seen better days, and so we need to try to use the Lacerator when possible, because can't use up all the durability in the sword. And I think I might have... No, that was my own fire resistance particles. I was going to say I might have seen a spawner above us, but no. But still, we'll get some light up here and over here. Oh, and here's more gold. All right. So it's like, oh, more gold. Actually, I can get more night vision potion. Oh, this is a lot more gold. Wow, this is way more gold than we found in the Titan Mines. There is another silverfish, and or two, which I do not enjoy seeing at all. And so I'm waking up some more silverfish here, but that's okay because I've still got... Oh, he just gave me some iron as well. All right. I might have to kill the silverfish with the sword in a moment. All right, that actually worked out pretty well. Let's get some more light, light, light. Okay, I found more Blazikins. You guys can go away. Silverfish are knocking me. Oh my goodness. All right, so there's a Blaze spawner somewhere around here that I wouldn't mind taking out. So let's see if we can find it. Of course not. Brian, find a spawner. You must be joking. All right. At this point, I have 27 levels. How much fire resist do I have? I still have 5 minutes of fire resist. Resisting of the fire. Imperviousness to the blaze. Unfortunately, there's a lot of silverfish, and I really need to find some spawners here. Because if I can't locate the spawners, then I'm gonna be in trouble. Silverfish and blaze spawners are what we want to take out. Blaze aren't that bad, but we've got too many of them right now. All right, let's try. Okay, I just saw him spawn again. There we go, okay. Spawner down. Great. I think that's the only blaze spawner in this corner. Silverfish on fire, so we can finish him off. Let's add some of our own torchlight over here to prevent future spawning of hostile mobs. And now let's see if we can locate one of these silverfish spawners. The fish! It's gonna be hard because now I'm spawning some due to me hitting them. Crap. Fish. Oh, and now there's a skeleton somewhere. Crap. Where's the skeleton? Here he is. Where did you come from? I do not know. Let's also make sure that this staircase is kind of very well lit, that I'll be able to find it again in the future. All right, armor's holding up okay. Don't need to worry about kind of regen kind of stuff. And I am getting lots of levels that I can use to repair my stuff. All right, and so long as we got the fire resistance, we're still doing pretty good. I see some kind of spawner cage down in the bottom down here. Yeah, it's lit up. Oh, diamonds! Do you guys see the diamonds? Of course you do. You probably saw them, like, 5 minutes ago. You're like, Brian, there's diamonds in this cave. Why aren't you going for them? All right, I'm going to have to go for them on the next attempt, I think. I think we need to go repair a pick and a sword and use these 21 levels for good. But yes, next run, I think we might get down to the diamond. We will see. Bootykin says, I need a fresh injection of iron stat. You got it, Bootykins. Hooray. And Chesty could also use some work. Hello, Chesty. Welcome back to the club. Do-do-do. All right. And unfortunately, the sword and the pick could also use some work, but I am out of levels again now. Yeah, I think we'll just have to continue on. All right, coming back in here, I had what I think is a great idea. I could just bring an anvil with me. And then every time I need to, you know, every time I get 9 levels or something, I can just walk back up here and use it. All right, so we're going to set down the anvil right there. And then I also brought golden apples for food. And so we'll have them as a backup. And I guess I'm probably going to need the fire resist potion pretty early on. But let's see what we can do this time around. All right, so the good news is got a lot of light in here. So we're going to be able to travel down pretty far before we encounter any resistance. Let's add a little bit more light over here and over here. And I think some blaze spawned around here and definitely silverfish. Okay, great. So let's go ahead. Let's drink that. All right. And so let's figure out where your spawner is. Hello, Blaze. Aha, I think I just saw it. Yes, it's right there. And so, do I want to let him spawn anymore? Yeah, let it spawn once more to get some more Blaziken friends. Let's also go ahead and get the regen potion on the bar. And the Blaze and the Silverfish are going at it. Oh, poor Silverfish. All right, great. Spawned one more Blaze, so now we'll go ahead and take out that Blaze spawner. But now those guys can help work in my favor as we continue to head in a downward direction. And so, Blaze, do your thing. Help me out. All right. I am terrified of what that is. It looks like it might be piglets. And so I do not want to get close enough to spawn anything over there until I'm absolutely ready. Which is probably going to be never. All right, I guess I should just bring a drink a speed potion and run over there with my super, what do you call? Yeah, let's do that. So, do-do-do-do-do. Got fire resist, so I shouldn't need that speed potion. Let's go ahead and hit you again. Let's get another speed potion ready in case I need it. And now let's run. Oh crap, it's piggy. Oh my gosh, so many piggies. It was already primed. All right, the good news is they suck at pathfinding. Oh my gosh, all right, this is okay. You're holding up. All right, need to eat. Let's be ready for a regen soon too. I've got golden apples now as good food. Yeah, I will regen when I need to, which may be soon. Okay. Oh, yep, more piggies. Another piggy. Wow, did he spawn from somewhere else? All right, that one's out in the open. Let's see. Let's go ahead. Let's take the regen potion. We'll have it for 2 minutes. Light. Piggy. All right, we got 2 piggies down. I don't see signs of other piggies spawning. The regen is going to make me relatively invulnerable. Let's go ahead and take you out. Let's get some more light in here for any other types of those guys' spawns. We'll also get the blaze to shoot at us, which will probably get some more light in here. Great, but it seems like we may have found a diamond mine. It hasn't exploded or anything, which is super fantastic, because, gosh, I'm nervous. I'm jumping all around like a madman. And I hear all these bats dying to whatever. All right, I guess while I'm still fire resistant, I have a fortune. I own fortune picks, actually. Crap. I should use them. Because having lots of diamonds could probably be a good thing. And there's silverfish spawn around here somewhere that I haven't found yet. And I hear silverfish dropping, but if there's nobody else that we need to worry about, and it doesn't look like there is, let's just add a little bit more torchlight. And then I guess we'll take out the blade. Oh, crap, crap! Oh, wow! Okay, so there is a creeper spawner somewhere. Probably up high, because I didn't even hear him. So let's try to get up there. Let's try to get up here. Oops. Add light way up here. Up there. I just want to see while I've got, you know, fire resist and regen, and I'm feeling pretty good, if there's any other bad guys afoot. But let's go ahead and start taking you out. Alright, one blaze down. Let's take out the other two blazes. Make sure that no other blazes are spawning. Alright. I should have thought of the fortune pick. Could have brought it along. Alright, and now, except for silverfish... Oh, nope, there's a skeleton behind me. Alright, let's take these guys out. Hello, skeleton. Oops, you're not dead yet? Alright, now you're dead. Yeah, okay. I think we have secured some diamonds. Let's add a little bit more light over here. I know that there is at least one spawner in here, and there's probably actually a lot more, but I've added so much light. Oh, crap! Found the silverfish. Alright, they're spawning from up above in the corner over there, and so I can actually go find that spawner, because these guys are going to be super annoying. They spawned out of the air. There it is. Great, and I have 17 levels. Let's go use the anvil to repair my sword and my pick. And then I guess I have to go back home and get the fortune pick, and we can mine some diamonds, and I'm going to bring back some gold, and everything is going to be super happy. Hooray! All right, Stabby, come back to life. Hooray! The iron pick of efficiency 5. You should come back to life. Oh, you take a lot more. All right, well, we will be able to mine up some whatever with the whatever, and then we'll be whatever. Yes, absolutely. Aha, I was mining some gold, and I just found another 2x2 fun box. Oops, which just gave me a bunch more levels, and so if I can manage to find another batch of spawners, or potentially just kill a bunch of silverfish, I might be able to level up right here in order to replace my pick, which is dying pretty quickly. Aha, found another silverfish spawner. Is it the only spawner here? Yeah. Alright, don't have enough levels to repair things over here, so gotta head home. Alright. I just saw a creeper fall from the sky, and I saw a spawner over there. I'm back with the fortune pick now. But it appears that we have a little bit of work left to do before we can actually mine the diamonds. Oh, darn it. You go away. All right, and so I didn't see where that silverfish just spawned. Oh, there's still more blaze. Holy crap. Well, I'm glad I brought another one of these. Wow. All right. It ain't over until it's over. And I know... Oh, darn it. Go away, go away, go away. All right, we need to find some spawners. Ouch. Let's add some light here. I know there's a creeper spawner above me. Okay, I just saw something flash right there. Okay, great. So up in that corner... Oh, there's the creeper spawner. Okay, great. And it's spawning blaze. It must be like a fun box, like right up there. Okay. I can handle this. I've got fire resist. I've got a regen on the bar. What I need to do is I need to build myself a better staircase up here. Gently use what remains of this pick. Because we got to keep this pick alive. But somewhere up in here... Crap. And now you're here. Crap, crap. Go away, go away, go away, go away. I'm on fire. It's hard to see. Alright. It's somewhere right over here. There it is. Okay, creeper spawner. Blaze spawner. And I think that might be it. Alright, and there is a creeper down here. Alright, hi creeper. Oh, baby. Alright, this room was not quite as easy as I thought originally. And I know there's at least a zombie spawner, because I saw zombies falling from the ceiling over here somewhere. Zombies I'm a little less worried about, but I want to make sure the room is completely safe. Oops. Before I turn my back. Oops. Silverfish, where'd you come from? All right, let's stand here and watch where the silverfish spawns. And let's also allow anything else to potentially spawn. Here's another silverfish. Darn it, the silverfish are everywhere. I'm not sure how to go looking for them. All right, one spawned right over here. Let's just stand around here, and eventually I'll see it spawn. All right, there are still silverfish spawning, but let's switch to the fortune pick and mine some diamonds, which will also give us some experience. And with a little bit more experience, I think we can not only repair, but also rename the efficiency 5 pick. Although, I could get up to level 30 and then just create a new diamond pick. Because I do like my armor. Let's get a sense of how many diamonds we're going to get here. Seems like a fair number of them. Okay. Finally! There was a silverfish spawner hidden way back three deep in the wall behind a diamond over here. And it was infuriating until I just found it. It's still a little bit infuriating. Whoa, game is lagging up for no good reason. Alright, I've decided that I will go ahead and repair and rename this guy. The efficiency 5 pick. And so we will call him Quickie to distinguish him from Quick for Minecraft exploration and tactics. And I have a bunch of diamonds at this point, enough to make a diamond block. I'll probably mine a few more. I'll leave a few here just in case somehow I die along the way back home, but I'll make sure I have enough for a suit of diamond armor as well as the diamond block that we need for the monument. All right. Well, I can get some satisfaction out of the fact that I can create a diamond block for the monument. Hooray! Sadly, we still have to go back in there because we still haven't found the wool. Recall that when we went in the entrance, I turned right. There was still more to go when you turn left. And so presumably that's where we'll need to go. But let's make a stop over at the wool monument. Diamond block. Kablam! All we have left, whoa, is the red wool and the black wool. Wow, but nevertheless, that's a pretty fine looking wool monument at this point. And my armor is still doing pretty well. And so, next time, we will go try to get one of the wools out of the Sands of Despair, and then go and try to get the other wool out of Null and Void the Revenge, or whatever the title of that area was. In any case, this has been a trial. The fourth intersection really is difficult, but I don't know if you guys have noticed so far, I am still alive. Ever since I put this protection armor on, I have not yet died. Let's go ahead and flash up my current death counter on the screen. I should probably take up the heads-up display so you can see me better over here. But, yeah, I'm feeling pretty good. I don't imagine that I'm going to be able to stay alive through Null and Void the Revenge, but maybe I can at least still stay alive throughout the rest of the Sands of Despair. So wish me luck. Hope you guys are having a great day, and I'll see you again soon.